So the second 2D transformation is a rotation. A rotation in which we will rotate an object about its origin with some angular specifications. Suppose we are having a point P having a coordinate x, y, which is at distance of r from the origin. With angle phi, suppose we rotate this with angle theta and move to the position P dash. So here we are having a point P to which we are rotating by an angle theta, and the distance is r. So we know that x equals to value of x will be r cos theta, and value of y is r sine, not theta, it's phi. Now when a position point P is rotated to P dash, value of x dash will be r cos phi plus theta, and value of y will be r sine phi plus theta. We will expand these two and we get r cos phi cos theta minus r sine phi sine theta. Similarly, we will expand this. We are applying the formula cos a plus b here and sine a plus b here. So r sine theta plus phi will be sine phi cos theta plus r cos phi sine theta. We will give this number 1 and 2, equation number 1 and 2. From equation 1 and 2, we will get the value of r cos phi and r sin phi. We will put these value in the given equation. We will get our answer x dash equals to r cos phi. We will write it directly, x cos theta, and write this as r sin phi equals to y. So y sin theta. Similarly, y dash equals to r sin phi, which is y, y cos theta plus r cos phi is x, so x sin theta. So this is the value of x dash and y dash, the new coordinate of P dash. With matrix representation, we will write them as, in matrix representation, we will write them as x dash y dash is equals to x y and r cos theta r sin theta, not r, it's directly cos theta and sin theta, minus sin theta and cos theta. So this is the our matrix representation of this rotation transformation. In this we have rotated the point P in the anti-clockwise direction. If this rotation is in clockwise direction, if clockwise, then this equation will be x dash y dash x y cos theta minus sin theta and cos theta. There will be a change in the symbol. So in general we can write this as P dash is equals to P dot R. Here R is the rotation matrix and value of R is in terms of a clock anti-clockwise direction, value of R is cos sin theta minus sin theta and cos theta. If it is in clockwise direction, then value of R is cos theta minus sin theta and cos theta. So this is the rotation transformation. We will see the numerical of this. So our question is this: rotate the point P having a coordinate 4 and 3 in a counterclockwise by 45 degree. Suppose this is our point P having a coordinate 4, 3 and we are moving it by 45 degree to the location P dash. So our question is this: find the coordinate of P dash when we are applying the rotation transformation. We know that the equation was this: P dash equals to P dot R. So first we have to find the rotation value R. As the rotation is given counterclockwise, so our value of R will be cos theta sin theta minus sin theta and cos theta. So value will be cos 45 sin 45 minus sin 45 and cos 45. So value of cos 45 and sin 45 is 1 by root 2. So we will get this 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 and 1 by root 2. So this is the value of our R. Now we will apply P dash. We have to find out P dash. So value of P is 4, 3. So write it this. And value of R is 1 by root 2. We have calculated it, minus 1 by root 2 and 1 by root 2. So for doing these operations, you should be aware with the matrix operations. Here we are applying matrix multiplication. First row with first column, first row with second column. Likewise, this will follow this. So we will get the answer 4 by root 2 minus 3 by root 2 first. Then first row, first column. Now first row and second column. 4 by root 2 plus 3 by root 2. So this is the answer. We can again expand this and we will get our values are 4 minus 3, that will be 1 by root 2, and this will be 7 by root 2. So this is the value of P dash. This means the new coordinates x dash, y dash is 1 by root 2 and 7 by root 2. So this is how we solve the problems related to rotational transformation. Next transformation we will see will scaling.